Okay, now we're going to write out a recursive implementation of that brute force solution to that subset sums problem that I talked about in the previous related lecture to this. So the idea is if I have three items, let's say W1 equals 2, W2 equals 3, 2, and W3 equals 3, just to be concrete, what I want to do is generate all possible solutions, look for the ones that are legal, and then pick the maximum out of that. My upper bound on the total amount of weight that I can have for this particular problem is 6. Okay, so the recursive solution to this, the recursive implementation of this, I'll just call that SS, and I give it J and W. J is notational convenience, and what J means, the set of all items up to and including J. Okay, so J minus 1, which we will see, that means the set of all items up to and including J minus 1, but not including J. J would be the next one to be listed. There's no particular, there is no ordering rule placed on the items, but once you have the items in an order, you stick to that order for this algorithm. W is the amount of weight that I am allowed to work with, that I can still add items to my subset, and as long as my total amount of weight for that particular subset doesn't exceed my W, capital W, then I can continue. So if I'm looking at this subset 1 through J, then the total amount of weight I'm allowed to have and not exceed is this lowercase w right here. So if J is the empty set, then I'm not going to be making use of any more weight, and I'm done, and just return 0. Okay, else, if I want to use item J, if I use item J, but the weight of J causes my total weight to go less than 0, then that's illegal choice. So J, if I want to test right here to see if J is even allowed to be considered. So if W, that's this W here, minus the weight of the Jth item is less than 0, then I want to calculate the optimal solution, just not considering J at all. Return SS. J minus 1, that means the set not considering J at all, and then my W, the weight, amount of weight I have to work with. Otherwise, I'm allowed to use J. So now I actually have two choices. I'm allowed to use J. That doesn't mean I have to use J. So I can either use J or not use J. So I want to choose between the better of those two because I'm trying to maximize the sum of my weights. So I want to return the max of, let's see, calling my SS function on J minus 1 and my initial weight. This means I'm not using the Jth item. So my weight that I'm allowed to work with doesn't change. Or I use the Jth item, which means that my score goes up by the weight of that J item, and then I look for the maximum solution where I don't consider that Jth item, because here's where the weight got used. And then the weight I have to work with is W minus W sub J. So those are my two options right there, if I am permitted even to consider J. Okay, let's trace this through to see how this works out. And so I have these three items right here and that upper bound that I'm working with right there. So the first time I call my function, I'm going to call it with SS and 3, and my initial weight is my initial 6. Okay, so and then we'll do a so sort of a terse activation tree down here. So I'm not in my base case right here. So 6 minus 3 is greater than 0. So this test fails. So I'm going to go down here and calculate the max. And I need to make two recursive calls. And I'm going to find the max between this recursive call. So that is J minus 1 and 6. That is, I don't use my item 3. Or the weight of item 3, which is 3, plus my recursive call, which is a j minus 1, so that's 2. And then I use that weight, so that would be 6 minus 3 gives me 3. Okay, that's my two possibilities. Okay, let's continue right here, where I'm trying to find the optimum solution for items 1 and 2, where I have 6 units of weight to work with. Okay, j is not equal to 0. 6 minus 2, w of 2 equals 2. I've got that right here. So 6 minus 2 equals 4. So this test fails. So I'm going right here, making two calls. Okay, the first call is if I don't use the 2 at all. So that gives me a 1 and the 6. And then the second call is if I use the 2, so that means I'll be adding in the weight of 2. Here's my to the result of the recursive call to 1. And then the weight, take away what the weight of 2 is, so 6 minus 2 is 4. All right, let us continue right here. So j equals 0, no. I have 6 minus the weight of 1, so 6 minus 2 is 4, so this test fails right here. So now I need to go down to here, and I'll be making two recursive calls to find the maximum. Okay, the first recursive call is where I don't use 1, so that's 0. 1 minus 1 is 0, and I'm not using it, so there's my weight right there. And then the second recursive call, I'll be adding the weight of 1, so adding 2 to it, and that is 0. And then my 6 minus 2 gives me 4 right there. Okay, so now I can start to return from these things. Sure, let me change colors, though, so that we can see a different color. J is 0, so I'm returning 0. Okay, here, J is 0, so I'm returning 0. There, okay, so now I've returned 0 and 0 from these two calls, and now I need to add right here WJ, so that's W1, to this 0 right here. So that's 2 plus 0 gives me 0. So the return value there is 2.